हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू निर्जा एजुकेशन। दिस इज क्लास 8, साइंस लेसन नंबर 1, क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन द इंक्रीजिंग ऑफ क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन। बिफोर सीइंग माय वीडियो प्लीज गो थ्रू माय प्रीवियस वीडियोस, देन ओनली यू विल गेट द कनेक्टिविटी। एट द सेम टाइम प्लीज सब्सक्राइब अवर चैनल, डोंट फॉरगेट टू प्रेस द बेल आइकन। नाउ we are getting to the particular portion, that is increasing of crop production. Why we want to increase the crop production? At present in India, population increases by about 20 million every year. According to our food requirement also increases. Our population is now over 1000 million, and yet we are able to grow sufficient food to feed the huge population. So definitely we need to increase our crop production. So we may think that increasing crop production means we have to use different kind of agriculture implement and new technologies so that we can increase. Before that, in order to addition of the systematic agriculture practices, we can do several other practices like these all are. First one is, there is, we can tell it is a fallowing, crop rotation. The third one is mixed cropping. The fourth one is hybridization. There are the four techniques we can use to increase our crop production. First, what is mean by fallowing? Fallowing is nothing but leave the cultivated land as it is without any cultivation. So land is left uncultivated for one or more season. So you may be thinking, what madam, you are telling about increasing the crop production, but you are out of the sudden you are telling you leave the land uncultivated. Means why we want to leave the land for uncultivated means continuously if you are doing cultivation on the crop land texture, that is a soil texture, may be changed. At the same time the nutrient content will be diminished. So if you leave the land for one or two season, automatically what will happen? The soil nutrient get replenished. So once again if you do the cultivation, you will get more yield. So that is the reason continuously we should not do cultivation. One or two seasons we have to leave the land as it is. That method is called the fallowing. I hope you have understood. Next one is crop rotation. Okay, what is mean by crop rotation? Here alternatively we have to change it. I have one small land, I am cultivating continuously rice only in the particular land. Means what will happen? Certain kind of nutrient, for example rice needed more amount of nitrogen. So if I am cultivating continuously every season this rice or something, means what will happen? My crop land texture may be changed or it may be affected. The particular nutrient content will be diminished. If I do for crop protection, alternatively I am changing the crop. For rainy season I am using rabi crops or rice or something. After that I am changing leguminous plant winter season. So every alternatively I am changing the crops, so I am managing the nutrient balance also. This is called crop rotation. So crop rotation is nothing but growing of crops alternatively. That is called crop rotation. So what is the use of the crop rotation? Means the farmer can get benefit for any situation. Suppose one time rainfalls are not there, means automatically the next session they get the benefit. One. Another one is soil texture will not damage. So nutrient replenish will occur properly. So this is the main motto for the crop rotation. The third one is mixed cropping. What is mean by mixed cropping? One particular land we have to cultivate two or three different type of crops are grown in a same land. That is called the mixed cropping. So for example, here you see this, two or more crops grown together in a same field, that is called the mixed cropping. So suppose three crops are I am selecting, so all the three crops are I am growing in a particular land. So I am getting different kinds of profit. At the same time one or two crops are not growing, another two will, the chances are there they can grow nicely. So for example, what are the crops we can grow together? That also some criteria are there. One, for leguminous pea plant. P pea plant or soya bean I can, otherwise cotton or groundnut. So this way I can select the two or three different crops I can cultivate in a particular land, that is called mixed cropping, right? I hope these three steps you have understood. Next we are going hybridization. The hybridization technique is also called cross breeding. So this is technological method. In the above the three is not a technological oriented, this is full and full oriented of scientific technologies, new invention. This is the hybridization. What is mean by hybridization? Hybridization is normally we can tell in our knowing word, that is we can tell as a cross breeding. So cross breeding means the same species we can interbreed, we can get the new variety. For example, I have two different varieties of mangoes in my garden. I have two different varieties. So one is sweet taste, another one is bigger in size but sour taste. One I have small one, sweet taste, another one I have bigger in size mango but taste is very sour. I want to make a new one with the help of this hybridization. What I am taking, I am selecting the two character. Before doing hybridization, we have to see the desirable character. So my desirable character is, I want big size of mango, at the same time it should be sweet in taste. So what I am doing, the both plant rendered is a reproductive organ. So anther and ovule, I am fused here. That process is called hybridization. So what happened, suppose plant A, big mango, plant B, that is a small mango. So here what I am, this is the mango tree is there, this also. So particular plant, that leaf, that flower is there, that flower I have to cut the anther. That process is called emasculation. Emasculation means removal of anther from the plant. So of course I have B plant, that anther is there. So that anther having pollen grain, that pollen grain I pass to flower A. So automatically cross breeding, cross pollination is occur. So that desirable character, whatever it is produced, the seed and the fruit may be whatever I decided. So the mango size also big, at the same time this also sweet taste. This way we can prepare the different kinds of species, but we have to keep it in your mind. Genera should be same but species should be different, that we have to keep it in your mind. Mango, mango, but we can take different this. Same like the raw rice and boiled rice, we can. So we can get the new varieties of rice. This method is called hybridization. I hope you have understood. Next we are going to discuss food obtained from animals. Like plants, animal also give us different type of food materials, particularly cattle like cows, buffaloes, sheep. These all are giving milk as well as milk product, at the same time different purposes also they are using. So those animals, rearing and maintaining of that animals are called animal husbandry. Here you see the domestic animals for the specific purposes is called domestication. This is called rearing of animals. Rearing means we are maintaining the animal in a particular area, particularly cattle. All the domesticated animals are used by a man is called the livestock. So those who are the animals are helping for the human being, that is called the livestock. The breeding, feeding and caring of livestock is called the animal husbandry. This is the definition of animal husbandry. Once again I read, the breeding, feeding and caring of livestock is called the animal husbandry. Like cattles, mainly animal husbandry is full made up of, that is a cattles like cow, buffaloes, these are rearing for milk and milk products. So those animals are called millage animal. Same like that, sheep and goat also reared for wool and meat purpose. Another one, poultry farming. So the poultries are nothing but birds for rearing meat as well as egg, that is called poultry farming. That is also helpful and come under the category of animal husbandry. Next one is physiculture. What is mean by physiculture means seafood such as fish, prawn and oysters are also consumed, as because they are contain rich amount of mineral as well as protein. So the rearing of rearing or breeding of fishes in a large scale, that is called pisciculture or also called fish farming. What is fish farming? Means rearing and breeding of fish in a large scale, that is called pisciculture or also called fish farming. Next we are going to discuss the last one is beekeeping. Beekeeping is also called apiculture. Here the maintenance of bee colonies commonly made by a man or human being, that is called apiculture. Here that honeybees are grown in a particular area. So why the honeybees are growing means because they are producing two different substances. One is honey, another one is wax. As we all know that honey is very very important, at the same time it contains some medicinal value also. So a beekeeper is also called apiarist. A location where the bees are kept is called, normally the bee hives are formed in a high tall areas, so that area is called apiary or also called bee yard. I hope you have understood what is animal husbandry. In the animal husbandry is nothing but breeding, feeding and caring of livestock in a particular area, that is called the animal husbandry. I hope you have understood this chapter. Thank you, have a nice day.